talking about Iran, because apparently people love Game of Thrones right now. And if you want to see more monarchies, eunuch advisors, if you heard his voice you'd know, fraud alliances fighting each other, and even official promotional materials, well, then you're gonna love this story. Let's just hope the nuclear winter isn't coming. This administration has been about as subtle with its feelings for Iran as the guy who clicks no on a Facebook invite. You're supposed to click maybe, soften the blow a little bit. They famously left the Iran deal to pursue a campaign of maximum pressure against Iran. And today, or probably yesterday, considering it takes a little time to edit these videos, maximum pressure just got maximum pressurier. Yeah, you'd think it would be hard to escalate from maximum pressure, but Pompeo found a way. Our new strategy is ludicrous pressure. Before I go into what happened on Monday, I have to give you a little perspective on Iranian negotiations. Well, it all started with...
I am announcing today that the United States will withdraw from the Iran nuclear deal.
That happened on May 8th, 2018, about a year ago. Then, on August 6th, we started our first round of sanctions. Wow, it took us 4 months? Kind of feels like we made a big deal storming out of the party and then had to awkwardly loiter on the lawn waiting for our Uber to come. The first round of sanctions really was felt by the 1% of Americans as we came down hard on Iranian carpets, pistachios, and caviar. Not the caviar! What about my decadent Western lifestyle? We also banned the sale of airplanes, cars, gold, and US dollars in Iran. Although, there's an unaddressed elephant in the room. Gee, we sure did stick it to them by making sure they couldn't sell carpets and caviar. Wouldn't want to touch that 72% of their exports that's oil. And this brings us to November 5th when...
The US is turning the financial screws on Iran, one of the world's biggest oil producers. Tough new sanctions will make the country's roughly 2.5 million barrels a day of oil exports toxic for buyers.
Yeah, that's when the hammer came down. Well, less of a hammer and more of a Bob the Builder mallet toy you give a kid so they don't hurt themselves. Because the US granted exemptions to 8 countries. To put that in perspective, I'll just throw up the countries Iran exports oil to and highlight the major ones we've given waivers to. China, India, South Korea, Japan, Italy, and Greece. So not quite explosive, but we shaved off about 10% of the exports. And this brings us today. Gave myself a little wiggle room there with the release date.
Last November, we granted exemptions from our sanctions to 7 countries and to Taiwan. With this, is to give our allies and partners to wean themselves off of Iranian oil and to assure a well-supplied oil market. Today, I'm announcing that we will no longer grant any exemptions. We're going to 0.
Oh man, that's huge. Remember, 72% of Iranian exports are oil. People are really bracing themselves for quite a few reasons. The first reason, and this is for those of you who don't have any sympathy for Iran, what's gonna happen to oil prices? I mean, Iran sells a ton of oil on the open market, and America's recently started getting pretty hippie with its oil imports. We only want ethically sourced, locally grown oil. Sorry, Venezuela and Iran. And this brings us to the first gamble this administration made. Do we trust Saudi Arabia? You can probably see I'm getting a little more excited right now because this is where the politicking really begins. You see, right now Saudi Arabia says they're gonna pick up the slack that will come from some people refusing to buy oil from Iran. Well, thank you Saudi Arabia for seizing on the most obvious business opportunity to ever fall into a country's lap. The question now is, which is larger, Saudi Arabia's love of money or hatred of Iran? Because they could take over oil production from Iran, make a little money, and we all go home happy. Except for Iran, of course. Or Saudi Arabia may decide higher oil prices would boost share prices for its giant state-owned oil company, Saudi Aramco. And boy oh boy, would that really just throw a monkey wrench in this machine that's already recovering from the last 30 monkey wrenches that were jammed in there.
The newly crowned prince is also the mastermind behind what could be a gigantic $2 trillion IPO listing of Saudi Aramco.
Yeah, Saudi Arabia's been teasing taking Aramco public for a while now. And honestly, it's been like watching Joe Biden drag out his presidential announcement. Saudi Arabia, we all know you're gonna do it. We have more important things to focus on. Just go public already so we can all move on. If oil prices were to go up, well, that certainly would increase the value of their stocks. So how much oil would they have to produce? Iran recently shipped 1.1 million barrels a day. The Saudis and the United Arab Emirates can increase their combined production by about 1.5 million barrels a day within a short period. So in theory, this could all work out just peachy. Although this brings us to the other potential shortfall of this plan, China. Specifically, we said, alright, we're canceling all waivers for people who want to buy Iranian oil. And then they said, yeah, okay, we'll get right on that. What are you gonna do, start a trade war? Tell you what, just throw those new sanctions on the pile with the rest of them. Remember, China imports 28% of Iran's oil, and that would almost definitely expand as other countries refuse to buy Iran's oil. As a representative of their foreign ministry said yesterday,
China has consistently opposed the US implementation of unilateral sanctions and the so-called long-arm jurisdiction. The cooperation between China and Iran is open, transparent, reasonable, and legitimate, and deserves to be respected.
Grab me some popcorn, because this is about to be quite the show. Any move by Beijing to keep buying Iranian oil, which analysts predicted China almost certainly will find some way to do, would force the United States to decide whether to impose sanctions on Chinese financial institutions. We're closing up negotiations on the trade war right now that's expected to be signed in May or June, and they're just looking at us like, feeling lucky, Trump? Go ahead, make our day. Even more unfortunately, China is Iran's largest oil buyer and has been increasing its purchases this year. Which, of course, if I make most of my money on a single product and people stop buying it from me, I'm gonna try to get rid of that excess inventory on the customers who are still here. Man, China's about to get a going out of business sale level of deals. That is, if the threat of more US sanctions doesn't scare them out of making that decision. Which, good luck with that one. The final piece to this puzzle is, well, the one group we've conspicuously not mentioned yet. What does Iran think about all this? Well, to put it lightly, they're not happy.
Iran responded defiantly, threatening to close the Strait of Hormuz, a strategically important choke point, if it is prevented from using it to sell its oil.
Now I realize most of you are thinking, oh no, the Strait of Hormuz! Somebody get me a map so I can figure out whether to be scared or not. Well, here you go, and wow, still not really sure if this is scary or not. Well, I would say it is the world's busiest transit lane for seaborne oil shipments. Now it's unclear how much they'll be able to do considering the US 5th Fleet is stationed in Bahrain, but Tufts University Maritime Studies Program director described it as, I think that Iran's looking at this as its one card, its trump card so to speak, where it could really disrupt oil prices in the short term. I know this isn't a term you should use when talking about Iran, but this really is definitely feeling like the nuclear option. The question is, have they been pushed to the brink yet? And when they get pushed to the brink, what are they gonna do? What this administration hopes will happen is, on paper, they'll come back to the negotiating table. You know, so we can get another Iran deal. Let's just hope their leaders have the memory of a goldfish. You'd have to be a sucker to not think that internal regime change is not on the mind of some of our leaders. On the other hand, some are worried that, with their economy having taken some major hits recently, let's just hope they don't do something crazy. Until next time, I think it's safe to say that Iran's economy might soon be yet another thing made in China. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the left of my head. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Also, this is the video summarizing Iran's economy. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.